It's one of the most fun apps to use on your iPad or iPhone, but particularly on your iPad, is GarageBand. It's a free app from Apple. And if you like music at all, it's just so much fun to play around with the different aspects of GarageBand. And it's easy to overlook some of them. For instance, I'm going to show you today this part of GarageBand called a beat sequencer. Now you can move around and see all sorts of different ways to start a song when you want to create a new one. If you look at the sound library, you can see there's a bunch of different stuff you can download, because when you get GarageBand it doesn't include all the different modules. And you'll see one that's called a beat sequencer. And you can see I've already downloaded this. And then when you go over to the drums section here, there are different ways. Like for instance, you can tap acoustic drums there and have a drum kit that you can actually tap on the screen. But there's also the beat sequencer. And the beat sequencer is a pretty simple idea. It's basically this timeline with these different instruments, and you check off boxes where you want there to be a sound. So for instance, for this drum here, I could put it right there and I get that drum played exactly where those filled in boxes are. So I could add in other ones as well. I can tap and drag. I can do all sorts of things to create this beat, and I could just keep editing it and playing around with it. If I get something I like and I want to use this as the basis for starting a song, I can simply hit the record button and it will record it, and I'll hit stop after it gets, say, 4 measures here. And now when I go look at the song, I'm going to tap the button there at the upper left corner to actually go to look at my tracks here. There's that track, and I can tap and shrink this down to those 4 measures there. I'm just going to double tap it there and switch it to a loop and have it loop through the entire thing. So now it plays, and now I can add other things to it. I can record instruments, I can record my voice, I'm just going to add some Apple loops here. So you just add some sort of interesting thing. I'm just going to add that to it. And continue to add things to create songs. But it all starts using that beat sequencer, which is super fun to play with just by itself. So if I double tap here on the instrument on the left, I can go back into it and continue to edit. And there's a lot on the bottom here. Right now I've got it set to the on or off for each thing. I can change the velocity, and I can actually adjust the velocity for each one. Note repeat, so I can tap and kind of have one note be a bunch of different notes by dragging up and down. There's all sorts of different things. I can even change the loop length for it. I see, there you go. So I can make this one say a shorter loop if I want, or a longer loop. I have the ability here to change the instrument, so it could be a different drum kit. I can choose from some predefined patterns to start with. There's a whole bunch of them. I can even hit the little random button there at the bottom, and it creates a random pattern for me. So I can just play around with that until I get some sort of random pattern as a starting point. So a lot of fun that you could have here playing around with the beat sequencer.